Hey there, I'm Sophia, and I'm going to walk you through how to inject Menopur under the skin or subcutaneously. These instructions are broken up into 5 quick steps. Let's start by making sure you've got all your supplies ready to go. Depending on your dose, a vial or more of Menopur. Each vial should contain powder or a pellet, a vial of sterile diluent, a syringe, a Q-cap for mixing, an injection needle, plus alcohol pads, a gauze pad or cotton square, a sharps container, and a clean surface. You may get prescriptions or supplies that use CC or ML interchangeably. Don't worry. They're just different names for the same amount of volume. For example, 1 cc is equal to 1 ml. Also, check to make sure the diluent is clear and doesn't have any particles floating around. If you see anything, don't use it and call your healthcare provider right away for next steps. Now, go ahead and wash your hands really well with soap and water. Then you're on to preparing the area where you'll give yourself the injection. There are a few places where you can inject your medication under the skin. In the abdomen, just below or to the side of your belly button, or in the leg, in the upper outer area of your thigh. No matter which area you pick, try to avoid injecting yourself in the same exact spot each time to lower your risk of a skin reaction. And never inject into any area that's tender, red, bruised, or hard. For today, I'll show you how to inject in the abdomen since it's the most common spot. First, use an alcohol wipe to clean the skin about 2 inches around the injection area. Then, give it a couple of seconds to dry while you get your medication ready. Up first, you're going to mix the diluent with the powdered Menopur. To get started, remove the caps from both vials and wipe the tops of each with an alcohol swab. Then, peel open the Q-cap pack. You're going to want to keep it in the package for the next step. Just be sure not to touch the spiky part. Place the diluent on a flat surface and hold the sides of the vial. With your other hand, turn the Q-cap pack over and place the open part on top of the vial. Push the spiked end straight down through the rubber stopper and into the vial until it snaps into place. If the Q-cap falls out of its package, toss it and use a new one. Once the Q-cap is securely in place, go ahead and remove its packaging and toss it in the trash. Be careful not to touch the connector end of the Q-cap. Next, you'll draw air into the syringe. So pull back the plunger to the amount of diluent your healthcare provider has recommended, usually 1 cc or 1 ml. Place the tip of the syringe into the connector end of the Q-cap and twist clockwise until it's tight. Gently press the plunger all the way in, which pushes the air into the vial and makes the diluent easier to withdraw. Without removing the Q-cap, turn the vial upside down and slowly pull back the plunger to withdraw the recommended amount of diluent. Then, go ahead and turn the vial right side up and pull on the syringe barrel to remove both the syringe and Q-cap from the vial as one unit. Just be careful not to pull on the plunger during this step. Next, place the vial of Menopur powder on a flat surface. Take the syringe you just prepared and slowly insert the spiked end of the Q-cap through the rubber stopper and into the vial until it snaps in place once again. Then slowly press the plunger to inject the diluent into the vial. Without removing the Q-cap, gently swirl the vial to allow the powder to dissolve. Then push the plunger down to remove any extra air that's in the syringe. You'll want to use the solution right after mixing. Without removing the Q-cap, turn the vial upside down and slowly pull back the plunger to withdraw all of the liquid. Be careful not to pull the plunger out of the syringe barrel. If your dose is more than one vial, use the syringe you just prepared to mix up to 5 more Menopur vials. There's no need to add more diluent. If you have any questions, call your healthcare provider. Once everything is mixed, twist the syringe to remove it from the Q-cap. Toss the Q-cap and vial into the sharps container. Next, twist the injection needle onto the syringe and remove the cap. To get rid of any air bubbles, point the needle up and gently pull back on the plunger or tap or flick the syringe until the bubbles rise to the top. Then press the plunger slightly until a tiny droplet of medication appears at the tip of the needle. A droplet is a good thing. It means your medication is ready to go. Now you're ready to inject the medication. So let's do it. Hold the syringe in one hand and with the other hand, pinch a fold of skin around the injection area. Insert the entire needle straight into the skin at a 45 to 90 degree angle. Slowly push the plunger until you've injected all of the medication. Do a quick count of 1, 2, 3, and then let go of the skin you're pinching. Press down firmly on the injection area with a gauze pad and remove the needle. Nice job! Now, your final step is cleanup. Go ahead and toss the used needle and syringe into the sharps container. And if you have any leftover Menopur that's been mixed, go ahead and toss that too. Thanks so much for watching today. Take care.